Our text, 1 Peter 3, verse 10 through 11. But the day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night, in which the heavens shall pass away with a great noise. Our heading, the world on fire. Men have frequently inferred liberty to sin from the apparent absence of God from the world, because the Lord, in his infinite long-suffering, has suffered transgression to go on for a while unpunished. Therefore they have wickedly said, "How does God know? The Almighty does not regard us. He will neither in fear to punish men nor to reward them, whether they break or keep his commandments." First, when for a long time no great changes have occurred in the world, no remarkable judgments, no visitations of famine, pestilence, or war, men are very apt to grow carnally secure and to take license to sin from the merciful patience which ought to have led them to gratitude and through gratitude to obedience. At certain periods, it has seemed to the Most High to be imperatively necessary to send great calamities upon mankind, lest pride, oppression, and profanity should cause society utterly to rot. Second, the fall of dynasties, the overthrow of empires, devastating wars, and dire famines have been necessities of God's moral government, bits in men's mouths, bridles for their arrogance, checks to their licentiousness. The Lord is slow to smite the wicked, for his tender mercies is great, and he delight not in the sufferings of men, and therefore he keeps his arrows in his quivers, and hang up his bow. But alas, men take advantage of his love to grow grossly sinful, and to blaspheme his name. The profanity, Securi had said, "Since the fathers fell asleep, all things continue as they were. Where then is the evidence of God's existence? The world go on like a clock, needing no hand to move its wheels or guide its action. There is no God, they say, to interfere, and we may live as we like." Application. Nope, says the apostle, but God has interfered. He put his finger upon the great event of the flood and say, here at last, at least, God did interfere. He could no longer bear the transgressions of mankind, and therefore he pulled up the sluices of the great deep and opened the floodgates of heaven. He bade the angry floods leap from their lairs, and they swallowed up the earth right speedily. And I pray, Father God, the sign of the rainbow says no more will the earth be destroyed by water, but you promised by fire. In Jesus' name, amen.